On Thursday, during Donald Trump's arraignment, the judge was very clear. You are not allowed to go out and intimidate anyone. You can't send any threats to anyone involved in this, potential witnesses. Doesn't matter who it is. Don't threaten anybody. Well, Trump made it about 24 hours before sending out a post on Truth Social that said, "If you go after me, I'm coming after you." That's it. Very simple post. If you go after me, I am coming after you. This was pretty much unanimously, except for the hardcore MAGA folks, perceived to be a direct threat against any and all potential witnesses against Donald Trump. So, Special Prosecutor Jack Smith on Friday issued an emergency filing with Judge Tanya Chakin, saying that we need a protective order to stop Donald Trump doing this, right? He is clearly threatening people with this post. Judge, do something. Judge agreed. Judge said, "All right, Donald Trump, your legal team, I will give you till Monday at 5 p.m. Eastern to submit your filing, basically explain what the hell your client did here and why he decided to violate the rules of the court. And then from there, I'll decide what to do." So over the weekend, I love going through these timeline type stories. Over the weekend, Donald Trump's lawyers asked the judge, "Hey, judge, we can't be ready by Monday. I mean, we need a little more time to try to spin this to our advantage here. So can you give us an extension? Because we just can't do it by Monday at 5 p.m. Judge Chakin said, "No, Monday 5 p.m. That's your deadline. I'm not giving you an extension." So then Donald Trump on Sunday did what any crazy person would do and decided to send out another post on Truth Social attacking the judge. Trump wrote, quote, "There is no way I can get a fair trial with the judge assigned to the ridiculous freedom of speech / fair elections case. Everybody knows this, and so does she. We will be immediately asking for a recusal of this judge on very powerful grounds, and likewise for venue change out of D.C. Best of luck with that. Judge Chakin has shown absolutely no bias one way or another towards you. She does not have any conflicts of interest that would say she should have to recuse herself from the case. So there's literally nothing you can do about that. Also, with the change of venue, you cannot put forward a sound legal argument to change the venues. And if you do find a sound legal argument that could be used to change the venues, well, then guess what? Jack Smith's probably just going to do the same damn thing and get a venue change from down in South Florida and get Judge Cannon kicked off that case. You're screwed no matter what, USOB. This man, Donald Trump, the former president of the United States, sent out a very clear and direct threat on Friday, a clear violation of the orders of the court. The judge was being nice in giving them till 5 p.m. on Monday. The judge could have immediately said, "Hey, listen, we gave you the orders. You responded in the affirmative that you understood them. Then you violated them. Guess what? We're not even going to have a hearing. I'm going to put your ass in handcuffs and put you in jail right now." That's what would have happened to any of the rest of us. Would have happened to me. Would have happened to you. If we violate a court order, we would immediately be held in contempt and put in jail. Immediately. No matter what. But Trump wasn't. He could be. The judge still has that authority. And if his lawyer's response by 5 p.m. on Monday is not satisfactory, he could be. He should be. This man knows exactly what he's doing. Again, not only is he now threatening anybody who would testify against him, he is specifically attacking the judge. There is no excuse for this. A gag order will not stop this. But by the way, his post on Sunday attacking the judge is obviously trying to get ahead of the game because he knows he is screwed with what he did on Friday. So he's trying to go ahead and portray the judge as being unfair because he knows he is about to get a ruling that is going to be absolutely devastating to him. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.